Psalm 68. Look what it says in verse 3. If you're righteous, this is what I want you to do, righteous man. Verse 3, 68 verse 3. But let the righteous be what? Glad. Where should they rejoice? Let them rejoice before God. Yes, let them rejoice exceedingly. Sing to God. Sing praises to his name. Why? Because the righteous has been adopted into a different family. So no matter the pain associated with your biological family, the moment you are righteous, you are now in the family of God. And can I just remind somebody that your God is bigger than Bill Gates, because he can pay any bill and open any gates. Come on. Your God is bigger than Warren Buffet. So once you say, I wish Warren Buffet was my father, or I was born into that kind of rich family, your God is bigger than Warren Buffet, because he can win any war and serve you a buffet. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Come on, somebody. Your God is bigger than Otedola, because even if you tear, he'll still give you some dollars. I don't know who I'm talking to, but your God is bigger than that. So he says, if you are righteous, you should rejoice. That means the righteous person can look at the Aborisha father and the DPM mother and the chief wizard of the village and say, I have a new nationality, a new identity. I've been redeemed out of every tribe and culture. Are you hearing what I'm saying right now? I have a new reference point. A new Jesus is my big brother. Come on. That Jesus is my big brother. The Holy Spirit is my chaperone. I know how to act and behave now because I belong to a royal family. That's why the righteous does not need to cry over the fact that your father used to abuse your mother. Yes, it can break your heart, but it must not break your spirit. You make a new resolution to say, it happened from those I was being born by, but even if I didn't come out of a good family will come out of me. I don't know who I'm speaking to, boy. You all don't look like you're ready for the kind of family we're talking about this month, but I'm talking about a family that you will not believe. God will bless you with a marriage that is so delicious, that is so sumptuous, that is so attractive, that is not only romantic, but it's actually going to make you tick like God. It will not only tick the right boxes, it will bring you out of the wrong boxes. Come on. God is going to bring you into a place where they will look at you and say, this is the kind of man I want to be like. This is the kind of woman I want to marry. You are going to be a definition, redefinition, reconfiguration of everything you did not have that God ordained for marriage. This month of February, the scales will drop you off your eyes. The limitations will be shattered. Even if you have not been in a relationship before, thank God you were not in one, because this series will equip you for the right kind of relationship and the right ones to say, I don't jam. I don't know who I'm talking to, but your next relationship will not waste your time. It won't waste your energy. It won't waste your heart. It will not waste your emotions. You will get it right.